As this newest immigration policy is signed into law, we're getting a better idea of why families are seeking safety in the U.S. to begin with. News Channel 5's Jonquil Newland spoke with local social workers about the dangers in Central America and Mexico and the trauma these families and children are going through. And Jonquil, this isn't about seeking the American dream.
Rory, these families are not fleeing to the U.S. to make money or take our jobs. They're crossing the border to save their children and family members from becoming victims of the drug war, gangs, and cartels.
The images of children in detainment centers along the U.S. border are heartbreaking, but they don't compare to the images many of these children have seen in their home countries or on their journey to a safer life.
If they don't join, they would execute them right away.
Mexico native Claudia Avila Lopez is a local social worker. Many of her younger clients have shared heartbreaking stories of family members being executed by gangs and cartels in Central America and Mexico.
They're also recruiting children, and when they don't join, then they kill them.
So many parents take the risk to try and cross the border to save their children.
When you think about the dangers that they're facing in their country, like, what's worse?
Beginning in April until today, children that made it to the U.S. were separated from their parents and put in detainment centers, a move that could have lasting effects on those young lives.
These youth, their brains are still developing, and this can be detrimental in terms of increasing risk for mental health disorders, depression, anxiety, post-traumatic stress disorder.
Dr. Mary Lehman Held has traveled across Central America and knows many families are simply attempting to save themselves from a fate of crime and murder.
The murder rates in El Salvador and Honduras are the two highest homicide per capita rates worldwide, and Guatemala is also in the top 10 of that list.
This is just a reality that most people are going through in Central America and many people in Mexico.
Now, you can help by contacting your senators and ask them to consider policies that would allow families to apply for asylum. Right now, asylum is rarely granted to those crossing into the U.S. Rory?